Thank you. Hi, I'm Roy.
Yes, you know.
Of course, you know.
Change is coming as we speak. You've seen the speakers speak about change today. Now, for the past 20, 30 years, every time Singaporeans ask questions, we ask the government to let us know what they are doing with our CPF. But the government will tell us that it is not in our personal interest to know. They will tell us that it is not in the national interest to know who is the nation. Are they the nation or are we the nation?
We are the nation!
Now, for the past 20, 30 years, the CPF became lesser and lesser. The 2.5% interest rate grew slower than inflation. The interest rates on our CPF became lower and lower. But the CPF minimum sum kept going higher and higher. In some years, it went above 10%. Now the government says that they want to increase the CPF minimum sum because of inflation. But why is it that the CPF minimum sum grew by more than 10% when inflation is only 2 to 3%? Today, we still don't have answers. The government says the CPF minimum sum is good for us. But when we are not even to save enough in our CPF to meet the CPF minimum sum, what is so good about the CPF minimum sum? Now, Singaporeans have been asking the government to let us know the truth for many years, many decades now. The government has always never wanted to answer. The government has never wanted to tell us the truth. But over the past 2 months, suddenly everything changed. Why did things suddenly change from May this year? What happened in May this year?
Because Hero Roy!
Roy is dead! Because Roy!
Now in 2012 and 2013, I found evidence on the government websites which proved that our CPF is invested in the GIC and Temasek Holdings. By May this year, the government erased this information on their websites. By May this year, the GIC still do not tell us that they are investing our CPF. They told us that they do not know if they are doing so. By May this year, Singaporeans still do not know if GIC and Temasek Holdings use our CPF to invest because they did not want to tell us the truth. By May this year, Singaporeans knew nothing about how our CPF is being managed by the government. Then all of a sudden, in June this year, for the very first time in history, the government admitted the truth that our CPF is invested in the GIC. Come out and say, I am sorry, this is the truth. They just published pictures in the Straits Times. They shared photos on their Facebook on the truth about the CPF and how it is being invested in the GIC. Why did they not say sorry to us? Now in June this year, the GIC, first the government admitted, now the GIC also admitted that they invest our CPF. And in June this year, for the first time, Temasek Holdings said that they do not invest our CPF. But is this the truth? An ex-director from the Ministry of Finance wrote a book and she revealed that since the 1970s, our CPF was invested in the Temasek Holdings. So how come the Temasek Holdings suddenly in June this year said that they stopped using our CPF? When did they stop using our CPF? May this year? They were set up since 1974. That is 40 years. Have they been using our CPF for 40 years before June this year? Now remember, Temasek Holdings earn high interest and GIC earn lower interest. So So why did our CPF suddenly got invested in the GIC and not Temasek Holdings? Suddenly in June this year, the government admitted to many truths. From not wanting to let Singaporeans know at all, now they bowed down to our pressure. Because we came here, and so they admitted the truth. In June this year, they admitted the truth. In June this year, I lost my job. Now, but why did the government take so long to tell us the truth? Why did the GIC keep pretending that they do not know whether they are using our CPF? Why did the government treat us like fools? The government knew since 1980s that the CPF was invested in the GIC and Temasek Holdings. Why did the government treat us like fools? We have to push for 30 years. We have to push for 30 years for the truth to finally come out. How many of us have lost our lives in the past 30 years? Now, how many of us have died fighting for answers? Now, how many Singaporeans have to beg the government for answers? And finally, in June this year, for the very first time, the government admitted the truth. It took them 30 years to admit the truth. I okay lah.
O level pass in Chinese.
那在2012和2013年的时候，我写了两个文章。那在这两个文章，我有证据，我找到证据在政府的网站，发觉到我们的公积金其实是投资在GIC的大马西中。 在今年5月，我在上网查，这些消息全被政府删除掉。忽然间，我们不知道我们的公积金是投资在GIC的大马西中的。
他害怕啊。
那但是在6月，今年6月，今年6月是头一次，政府在40、50年内跟我们承认，他们把我们的公积金投资在GIC里。 为什么50年了，他们都不肯跟我们讲？但是等到今年6月，没办法被逼，才跟我们讲。在今年6月，大马戏也说他们没有投资我们的公积金，但是有一个 director 在 Ministry of Finance 写了一本书说，其实从1970年开始，大马戏就投资我们的公积金。那大马戏其实在哪一年？ 停止投资我们的公积金呢？5月吗？那政府需要对我们老实一点。政府没有坦白的跟我们说，他是在报纸放了一张报纸一张消息说，其实公积金有投资在 GIC， 而我们不要这样的对我们很像很随便。我们要知道，如果你有用，你就站出来，挺身站出来跟我们说你有用我们的公积金。 每个新加坡人道歉，对，三十、40、50年来，有多少个新加坡人因为拿不了我们的公积金，笑死，对，这把报纸卖掉，对，这个不是你可以在报纸放出一个消息，我们就可以原谅你的东西，你要你就跟我们说对不起，对，整个国会跟我们说道歉。 你已经40、50年知道了，你敢跟我们说？现在6月才知道，丢脸吗？没有信用啊！没有信用。Now the CPF is our money. It is our hard-earned money. The government says that the CPF is not a cheap source of money for them to use. But the government takes our CPF and gives only 2.5%. And 4% to Singaporeans. Then they take our CPF to earn 5% at the GIC. And in the past, 16% at the Temasek Holdings. and they give us 2.5%. The CPF is not a cheap source of funding. Our CPF is very cheap. Who in their right mind would give someone else their money, accept only 2.5%, and then tell them you can take my money and earn 16%? Will you do that?
No! Never!
Now we should take our money there, money back, and tell them you cannot touch our money until we give you the permission to do so.
Right.
Yeah. But will they let us?
No.
Now will they let us?
No.
The government tells us that 2.5% is fair. They say that GIC take on the risk for Singaporeans and give us a secure interest rate. Now is this true?
No!
It is Singaporeans who are taking on the risk for the GIC. We keep working so hard. We keep earning CPF. Now without our CPF, the GIC and Temasek Holdings will not have this money to use.
Yes, you're right.
Now it is Singaporeans who are taking on the risk. Without the CPF, the GIC and the Temasek Holdings will amount to very little. If the GIC and Temasek Holdings need money, the government will give them more money. They call it capital injections. But where does the money come from? If Singaporeans need the money to be returned to our CPF, will the government give us more money?
No! Yes!
Now they pay us 2.5 to 4%. They happily take our money to invest. If we do not take on the low interest rate, will they have the money to invest?
No!
Mr. Chiam Si Tong also said, imagine your uncle ask you to save and invest 36% of your income through him, now 37. He gets a return of 12% and gives you 2.5% of it. The excess returns are kept by him. He also tells you, you have no choice because only he knows how to take care of you. Then is he really taking care of you or is he taking care of himself? Now the government says that the GIC is taking on the risk for Singaporeans, but it is true that the Singaporeans are taking on the risk for the GIC.
That's right.
So GIC earns more and more money while Singaporeans earn less and less on our CPF. Now if indeed GIC and Temasek Holdings have been taking our CPF to invest over the past 3 to 4 decades, it is time the government comes clean with Singaporeans. One, how much did the government use our CPF to invest in the GIC and Temasek Holdings? Two, how much of the returns that they earned in the GIC and Temasek Holdings that were not returned? Three, how much tens and thousands of billions dollars were earned by GIC and Temasek Holdings but were not returned? Four, these returns have to be returned back to Singaporeans! Yeah! 假如政府拿我们的公积金投资在GIC的大马金中， 我们需要问他们一些问题。 一, 你到底从我们的公积金拿了多少 投资在GIC的大马C？ 二, 你在大马C和GIC赚了多少利息？ 这些你要跟我们讲。 三, 到底在GIC的大马C赚了多少钱？ 四, 你所赚的钱，从我们的公积金所赚的钱， 应该还给新加坡人。 But you know what? Actually, the government should reward Singaporeans for giving them our CPF to invest. First, the government never asked if they could take our CPF to invest. Then, the government take our CPF and say they have the right to use it. Finally, they tell us they should keep the interest earned and give us a little back. But what about Singaporeans? Have we ever given them permission to use our CPF?
Yes! Who's the
Now if the government takes our CPF to invest, they should be rewarding us. We shouldn't be rewarding them.
That's right, that's right.
Now we are not beggars asking for bits and pieces of help from the government. We have dignity. But the CPF is our money. If you want to use our money, you jolly well pay for it. If you want to use our CPF, you better pay us good money for it. Now the government's allegiance should be to Singaporeans. We voted for the government to protect us, to take care of Singaporeans first. Now we did not vote for the government to take care of the GIC and the Temasek Holdings first. Now is the government more interested in taking care of the GIC because they are also on the board of the GIC? Now if the government doesn't know, if the government knows not to bite the hand that feeds it, then the government jolly well know that without Singaporeans, without all of us, they won't even have the money to use.
There's no Singapore!
Now they can act like princes now because of our money. So lest they forget, we are the masters. And lest we forget, we are the masters! So if they want to use our CPF to invest, they better pay us good money for it! If they want to use our CPF to invest, ask us nicely. And we will decide if we want to let them use our CPF to invest. Now the CPF is our money. Why did they become the money lender instead of us? Why did they become the money lender and threaten us with our money? When it is our money. Now the president of Singapore is supposed to take care of our CPF. Today, what has he said about the CPF? Has the President Tony Tan helped Singaporeans ask any hard questions on what is going on with the CPF? What is the government doing with our CPF? Does Tony Tan know these answers? Does he know these answers when he was the Deputy Prime Minister of the government? Does he know these answers when he was the Deputy Chairman of the GIC? As the President of Singapore today, has he asked his questions? Now will the real Tony Tan please stand up?
Yeah.
新加坡的总统, 他应该是照顾人民的公积金，但是到了现在, 他有没有为了我们问公积金到底在哪里？ 当时他是副总理的时候，他知道我们的公积金在哪里吗？知道。当时他是在 GIC 做 Deputy Chairman， 他知道我们的公积金在哪里吗？知道。清政府啊！那为什么？为什么他还没有问到问题？干家。Now in 2011, Parliament reviewed that the median CPF life payout every month is only $260 every month that we can take from our CPF. This means that more than 50% of Singaporeans can take less than $260 every month. Last week, for the first time ever again in our history, for the first time, the government admitted more truths. After hiding for so long, the government finally revealed the truth. Today, we know that as many as 85% of all Singaporeans cannot meet the CPF minimum sum. Now the government says the minimum sum will let Singaporeans take out $1,200 every month. But when 85% of Singaporeans are not even able to take out $1,200, What is the use of the CPM minimum sum? In fact, 50% of Singaporeans might not even have 60,000 in our CPF. If so, we won't even be able to take out $500 every month. 那政府跟我们说，他们需要放一个 CPM minimum sum， 因为这样新加坡人才可以每个月拿千二。但是其实85%的新加坡人连这个底薪都拿不到，我们连千二都拿不到，甚至58%的新加坡人连6万都没有，在公积金都没有，所以我们连600块都拿不出来。如果我们拿不出这个钱，这个 CPM minimum sum 哪来做梦的？
多余的垃圾，哪来控制我们钱？给他们陪葬啊！给他们陪葬，给他们用啊！
Why did the government implement the CPF minimum sum, knowing full well that the wages that they are paying now, knowing full well that the CPF interest rates they are paying now, will never, never allow us to meet the CPF minimum sum?
一个，一个，一个。
Is the government's planning so bad? Or does the Singapore government does not care about Singaporeans? Now the government told us that the CPF rates are far higher than the equivalent rates provided by similar products out in the market today. Now that I don't have a job, I will invest my CPF and see if this is true. I can share my investment history every month. Now I know someone who invested her ordinary account in early March and has made a profit of about 3% on about 40% of the portfolio only after 4 months. This means that she has already got a partial return of 3%. And this is still higher than the 2.5% that the government is giving us. How much will she get in a year? 9%? 9% is way higher than 2.5% or even 4%. So let's see if what the government wants us to believe is truly right. Is 2.5% really higher than other similar products? Now for the first time ever, the government finally reveals that Singaporeans have to spend half of our CPF on housing. The CPF is our retirement fund.
Yes.
It is not the housing fund.
Yes.
Now why did the government make us pay half of our CPF for the flats? They tell us to pledge half, to pledge our home to get back half of our CPF. What is the logic in that? Is this bad planning or does the government not care? Finally, Khaw Boon Wah admitted in Parliament last week. He said, firstly, we control the construction programs. Secondly, we set the price for the flats. So finally, the government admits the truth. If the prices of HDB keeps going up, who are the ones who keep pushing them up? If Singaporeans cannot afford our homes, who are the ones who made it difficult for us to buy our homes? If Singaporeans cannot save enough in our CPF to retire because we do not have enough in our CPF, who was the one who made it impossible for us to retire?
政府在上个礼拜跟我们第一次说，他们的建筑、那个活动是他们控制的，物价多少也是他们控制的。那如果我们在公积金里拿不出钱，因为我们把我们的公积金还给屋子了，那是政府的错还是我们的错？政府的错。
In 1983, the Straits Times reported that the government borrows our CPF to give the HDB to build the flats. HDB then lend us the money at a high interest rate to buy the flats. how come the government borrows our CPF? They earn from it by lending it back to us.
HDB,
the government also wants us to pay an accrued interest. If you sell your flat, they say that because you borrowed money from your CPF, they couldn't give you the 2.5% on it. Now they want you to pay back the 2.5% that they couldn't give to you. Does this make sense?
No! $8.
Now the CPF is our money. But the way the government is treating it, is it still our money or is it the government's money? Now today, we know that we do not own our homes. The government keeps saying that Singaporeans, we own our homes, but we don't. We only lease it from the government. For the very first time this year again, because of a question by the Workers' Party, Derek Yang, the government admitted that our homes will have no value, zero value, by the end of the lease. Then our homes, still our homes. Kovuwa admitted last week, firstly, we control the construction price programs. Secondly, we set the price. Now Kovuwa also said, once the lease on our homes end, our HDB flats will go back to the HDB. Because HDB owns the land, then we don't own our homes. Why does the government still tell us that we own our home?
They call us!
那政府在今年第一次跟我们透露, 老实地跟我们透露, 其实我们的屋子在请辞几年后, 一分钱都没有, 根本不值得。 政府也跟我们说, 其实屋子在九十几年后, 不是我们的, 是HDB所管的。 那如果这个屋子根本不是我们的屋子, 政府为什么要我们拿我们的公积金去买这个屋子? 啊。 Today, we know that it costs at most $100,000 to build a flat. Then why does the government ask us to pay $300,000? What happened to the $200,000?
Bonus, bonus.
If the land,
18-month bonus.
If the land is owned by the government, then why do they need us to pay another $200,000? Now what is the purpose of public housing? Dr. Goh Keng Swee has envisioned public housing to be for the masses. Public housing, low-cost housing, which can provide a roof over our heads. Dr. Goh Keng Swee, he wanted to give us a home. Now he wanted Singaporeans to have a home we can call our own. Dr. Goh Keng Swee wanted us to live in a home we can be proud of, to live in a country we can be proud of. Dr. Goh Keng Swee had a dream. But what happened to this dream? Now the OPP has a vision for Singapore. They had a dream. They wanted to create a home for Singaporeans. Ko Chin Chai, S. Rajaratnam, Dr. Goh Keng Swee. They wanted a place that we could live in and be happy in. The OPAP was a responsible government that took care of the people. 以前的PAP 是一个会照顾人民的PAP, 是一个有心的PAP, 会关心, 会了解, 会慷慨对待我们的PAP。 但是现在的PAP呢, 他们有没有这个心?
黑心，他们有黑心，
你们都。
Amateur, commercial, commercial.
Not the same.
Commercial fiber limited.
The same. Cannot be said for the PAP today. The PAP today is of course very happy. Sitting with their $1 million salaries. How will things ever be too expensive for them? But of course, they will never understand how it feels like to be poor, to be unemployed, or to have to fear for your lives, day in, day out. But I do. I love my job. They fired me.
You are a hero! You are a hero!
Like many of you, like many of you,
we support you, right?
I fear.
You are not alone. The matter belongs to us.
Yeah. Like many of you, I fear whether my life will still be protected. I fear whether there's a government which will have the integrity and dignity to take care of our lives, of all Singaporeans. When I lost my job, the government sent a press release to support my sacking. Which government in the world will send a press release to celebrate its own sacking of its own citizens? Which government in the world will laugh and cheer when its own citizen is left out in the cold, unprotected, and scared? And then blame you for not working hard enough? 真的是你有哪一个政府会把你炒鱿鱼然后跟媒体讲我炒了他的鱿鱼我们炒那个鱿鱼
Yes!
我们炒到你们要不要炒到还没有炒到
2016年
炒他的鱿鱼哪里有一个政府会说如果你们生活不够好
是因为你们不够用功，是因为你们懒惰。新加坡人在这世界上做最长的时间，我敢讲，我们还比我们的部长做更久。我的不用功，难道他们这么用功，可以拿他们现在所拿的薪水吗？ Now this is not what the government should do to leave its citizens out in the cold. The government is supposed to take care of its people, to protect them, to protect us, and to give us a secure place to live in.
That's right.
Now this is what the old PAP understood.
Yes.
This is what the old PAP believed in.
Yes.
They made it happen. They created a Singapore that we can be proud of.
Yes.
30 years ago. But does the PAP today know this?
No.
Do they know how it feels to be unemployed? And so how important it is to have unemployment benefits? Do they know how it feels to fear not have enough to pay when you go to a hospital? And how people choose not to go to a hospital? And so how important it is to have higher health subsidies? Do they know how it feels like to have to work so hard as a cleaner, as a hawker, and to devote your time and energy to commit into your job? And how these jobs require passion and skills, as every job does? And how our workers should be paid higher salaries. Do they understand this? Now I do. I have lost my job. I have had to fear going to the hospital over the past 2 months. I have had to take on odd jobs. When you go to Starbucks, and the first thing you do is not look at which drink you like to drink, but which drink is the cheapest and you buy it. When you stop going to Starbucks and you stop going to restaurants, even when you have to meet your friends there. You eat something cheap outside before you meet them there. When you lie in bed at night, feeling the pain shoot right through you. But you endure the pain because you know you cannot afford to lose a few $100 at the hospital. When you break your back cleaning the toilets and stand for hours in the heat trying to remember the food orders for the customers, you realize how important it is, how every job has its value, how every of us has our value, has our dignity, and no matter what we do, we put in our passion. We are committed. If I'm a cleaner, I'm a CEO, I'm a teacher, I'm a bus driver, I'm a security guard, I do it because I believe in it. I believe in my job. Can the PAP understand this?
You understand money, money!
Now will the PAP still have the integrity? Can they have the integrity to pay us a minimum of $1,500 to $2,000 at least? Because we are of value. Will the PAP have the honesty to increase health expenditure to 70% like all the other advanced countries do, instead of the 30% now? Will the PAP have the justice to return our CPF to us after years of earning from our CPF? Now what we want are not grand stories of how the CPF rates are fair when they are the lowest in the world. Now what we want is not to know that the CPF minimum sum is good enough when 85% of us cannot retire on it. Now what we want is a PAP that will take care of us, that has the integrity, the honesty, and the justice to take care of the people. Because the pledge, we, the citizens of Singapore, it's very simple. If you want to give high interest rates to Singaporeans, you will. You will not tell us that low is fair. The solution for our CPF is very simple. One, let us grow our wages, let our CPF grow. Two, increase the CPF interest rates so that our CPF will grow. When our wages and our CPF interest rates will grow, our CPF will automatically grow. Then do we still need the CPF minimum sum?
No! Void the minimum sum!
Void! Now, if the government only wants to put in the minimum sum, knowing full well that if our wages and CPF interest rates do not grow, that we will never be able to meet our CPF minimum sum, then the CPF minimum sum cannot be called a solution.
We will vote minimum sum rubbish policy.
Now the government, be completely honest to Singaporeans what you are doing with our CPF in the GIC and Temasek Holding. Four, give Singaporeans the choice as to whether we want to invest our CPF. Fifth, give the CPF to the CPF board and let an independent body invest the CPF. Yeah. Now a survey has been done today. More than 50% of Singaporeans believe that the CPF interest rates are unfair. Yeah. The government might say that the interest rates are fair, but we have our own eyes to see. Today, nearly 60% of Singaporeans think that housing is not affordable. The government might say that housing is affordable, but we have our own eyes to see. Today, 80% of Singaporeans say that the cost of living is too high. The government might say that things are cheap, but we Singaporeans, we have our own eyes to see. Now the government tells us that if wages increase, prices will also increase. And so they cannot do that for us.
They can do $8 for surgery.
But why is it that wages have not grown, but prices have grown? Who caused the prices to grow?
Government!
They only spend $8 can go up.
Now 50% of Singaporeans believe the interest rates on our CPF are not fair. 60% thinks the flats are too expensive. 80% thinks the cost of living is too high. Then what exactly is the government trying to do to Singapore? Now the government has made the GIC and Temasek Holdings private limited companies, so they do not have to explain to Singaporeans what they are doing with our money.
We are the shareholders!
But the GIC and Temasek Holdings use our CPF to invest. The GIC and Temasek Holdings use public funds, Singaporeans' money, your money to invest. They cannot make the GIC and Temasek Holdings private companies when it is public funds they are using. To come clean.
Okay, wait there.
Turn these companies back into public companies and give us full reports and tell us what you are doing with our CPF. Now the government cannot use our retirement funds to make money for themselves. No, this is not what the government should do. The government cannot take our money and make. Cannot take our CPF and make money at the HDB. No, this is not what the government should do. The HDB cannot take our CPF and make money for themselves. No, this is not what the government should do. And the GIC and the Temasek Holdings and the government on the GIC cannot take our money to use. This is not what a government should do.
Is the government a CPF? Is the HDB?
And once the government lets power and money gets into their head, the government is as good as gone. And as a people, we have to stand up. We have to rise. And we have to fight and protect ourselves and one another. But Singaporeans, are you ready? My friends!
Legit the government!
My friends!
But as we throw the money every month!
My friends! Our country will only survive as long as our people have hope. And as long as our people believe in our country. Our country can only survive when we understand the stakes we have in our own country. To learn that in order fight for our country, our rights, and our freedom, that this means that we have to take a step forward. That this means that we have to take a stand.
Make a change!
The battle belongs to us!
Make a change!
It means not waiting for change to happen, but be the change we want to see. It means not hoping that one day the government will change, about to change the government.
Kick our long out.
Now be the change we want to see. country, for our lives. We need to believe in a dream. If we want justice, equality, and freedom to come to our country, we need to believe in it and make it happen. Now we need to step forward, join hands, and make it happen. Now can we do it?
Yeah!
Now today you have come here. Now give yourselves a round of applause.
Singaporeans, PAP, and everyone else of us alike
can shower in our glory and our achievements together. So when we share in our country's growth, when we share in our country's opportunities, and if we fall, we will help one another up. And if we succeed, so will one and all of us. Now this is the country that I dream of, that I have seen happen in other countries, and in Singapore in the past. Now this is not a dream, it is a reality. But only we Singaporeans, only we can make it a reality.
如果我们要一个公平的国家，不要只想，不要只当作是个梦想。如果我们要我们的国家变成一个比较公平的国家，让我们站出来实现它。
And only when the PAP cooperate with Singaporeans and the PAP are able to come down from their pedestal and be the people. Now be the people. And only when all the parties, all the political parties are able to put aside our differences and step up with bravery, only when our people have the awareness to reach out to one another, to speak up, and to learn our own rights. Only then can we prosper towards a new beginning. Now today we speak. Tomorrow, many more will. And soon, all of us will. Now if we want the change to start, change starts from us. Because, now being the change we want to see, and only when we believe will our dreams come true, and only when we believe will our country succeed for all of us, we all of us, and only when we believe will we see the fair and equal society that we have always, always been wishing for. Now onward, Singapore! Thank you. Now my pre-trial conference has been postponed next week, Thursday, 17th July at 2:30 p.m. The court date has been set for 18th September at 10 a.m. The Prime Minister has asked for a summary judgment. Now I would like to thank my lawyer, Ravi. I would like to invite my lawyer, Ravi, up on the stage.
Thank you very much for your support and kindness. As you know, the Prime Minister has taken out an application for summary judgment against Roy. As his lawyer, I will assure you that I will fight this case vigorously and stand with him. At the end of the day, history has shown us whether we lose or win this application, the will of the people will finally prevail. Yeah. For now, I will keep my aggression for the court.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for all your support, and together, we can see the Singapore that we have always dreamed for.